Hello and welcome to Universe Mode. This is Tuesday Night Raw. We've traveled to Rhode Island because that's how we do things around here, apparently. We are one night removed from the biggest event of the summer. The fallout from SummerSlam is here, but we are starting things off with Prince Puma in one-on-one action. Prince Puma is going to be the first man to go one-on-one, albeit in non-title action, but he's going to go one-on-one with the new Cruiserweight Champion, Daniel Bryan. Here's the first spoiler for SummerSlam for you, and of course if you saw the thumbnail to this video, you would have seen the second spoiler. More on that later. Right now on Raw, three new champions, one of them of course, as I just said, being Daniel Bryan, your Cruiserweight Champion. On his way to the ring, the third ever Grand Slam champion in this universe. Daniel Bryan last night defeated Neville in a very back and forth match. Either man could have taken it, but it was Bryan via the Yes Lock, and that enabled him to win the Cruiserweight Championship. That enabled him to get where he wanted. So there we have it, Daniel Bryan. Congratulations to him on what he achieved last night at SummerSlam. But here tonight is where the work of the champion begins. Daniel Bryan knows what it's like to be a champion. Let's see how he does a little bit lower down the card than before, but still with the Cruiserweight Championship. Alright, so Prince Puma and Daniel Bryan, pretty interesting way to start things off here on Monday Night Raw. Let's talk through tonight's match card as well to see what things are looking like. After this, we have another bit of fallout from SummerSlam. The World Tag Team titles contested between the Killer Elite Squad and American Alpha. The Killer Elite Squad, in a way, decimating American Alpha last night, proving why they are World Tag Team champions, in my opinion, with a great showing against American Alpha, isolating them in their corner and just in general being able to control them as easy as they did was the ticket to the Killer Elite Squad success. However, tonight, Chris Benoit is going to go one-on-one with Chad Gable, which should be interesting enough. Then to follow up from that, we are going to see the new United States Champion, Christian, in action. He will be going one-on-one, if memory serves me correct, with an opponent. I know, it's shocking. I wish I remembered who it was. Jay Lethal. That's who he's taking on. He's taking him on one-on-one. There you go, Jay Lethal getting a nice opportunity here to go to be the first opponent for the new Cruiserweight Champion. And in our main event, AJ Styles will take on the new World Heavyweight Champion, Finn Balor, in what was a very highly anticipated main event. Finn Balor, the Demon, showed up. Simple as, the Demon showed up at SummerSlam, taking the title away from Tyson Kidd. Kidd, of course, as you just heard from the card, not here tonight on Raw. Perhaps a smart decision that he isn't, considering just one day removed, and the Demon is here with that World Heavyweight Championship. However, as we get closer to the next pay-per-view, you never know. Tyson Kidd could wind up finding a potential way to come back at Finn Balor. Perhaps a rematch down the line. Perhaps a rematch at the next show. We'll see what's going to happen regarding that. But Finn Balor, right now the World Heavyweight Champion. Tyson Kidd should be entitled to a rematch considering how the way in which he won that World Heavyweight Championship, making a man in this ring, Daniel Bryan, tap out. But we'll see what's going to happen regarding that. Of course, rematch clauses aren't usually just handed out in this universe. You do have to fight to get your opportunity back. Nobody home. Because Prince Puma, they're wanting Daniel Bryan back in the ring and then to quickly just decide to throw him back out of the ring. That didn't go well. Bryan there with a quick forearm. I'm going to try and hit the top rope here. Is he going to be able to take flight in time? He is, but he misses the drop kick. Puma went for a move there. Gets countered and Bryan kicks him in the leg. Here goes Bryan now. Kicks to the chest. We're going to get that one across the head eventually. The might be the one to get him close to sealing the deal. There it is, across the head. Bryan backing up to the turnbuckle. Here we go. If he hits this, it's over. No, it's countered. Oh, when is it ever not countered this rate? Up on his shoulders now. Oh, single knee gutbuster. And a sent on to follow it up. Bryan gets out of the way of Puma's attempted stomp. Didn't get out of the way of that kick. And counters the backbreaker there. Bryan leaping over the top rope. Now Bryan going to take flight here. Leaping. Oh my god. Corkscrew kick by Prince Puma. What a move by Puma. Cover on Bryan. Can Puma pull off an upset win? He cannot yet. Daniel Bryan kicking out of two, and Puma frustrated, it seems, about the count. Nothing wrong with it. Entirely fair count there by the ref.
Nice reversal by Bryan. Yeah, that's where Brian's quickness really
good reversal there, and now these two men just kind of having a stare off with each other. Daniel Bryan, I think, still trying to recover from that incredible corkscrew kick from Prince Puma. Good kick to the back and slams him down there with a good clothesline. Bryan gonna fly again, maybe? Yes, seems so. Climbing up the top turnbuckle. Seems a little bit tired, catching his breath here. Gonna fly. Oh, this time, Puma. Well, he had so much time to just be able to get out of the way. And that paid dividends. Puma moving out of the way there very quickly. And now Daniel Bryan once again on the back foot. Puma, the one in control, turns over. Oh god, actually, oh, Puma was gonna look for the top rope, but Bryan's getting up to his feet. And oh, big drop kick. This could backfire awfully. No, Puma counters. Puma might look to fly. Oh, and he gets it. Double knees there. Puma gonna go up to the top rope again. My goodness, Prince Puma is pulling out an amazing performance here. Phoenix Splash, oh, he misses. Daniel Bryan getting out of the way of that. But Puma not letting Bryan get anything going here. Sending him down into a side headlock. That's just what you do after you miss a Phoenix Splash. And then Bryan able to get out of it with ease. DDT! And I think Bryan just got busted up. And my goodness, we're blading in the first match of after SummerSlam. The first match tonight. We've already got blood. Good counter there by Bryan. Oh, Bryan! He used this move last night to win the Cruiserweight Championship. Yes, lock on Puma to put him away here. To kickstart his Cruiserweight title reign with a win, and he does just that. Daniel Bryan makes Prince Puma tap out. Puma came close, though. Definitely came close indeed, but it is Daniel Bryan, your winner here tonight, as we start things off on Monday Night Raw.
Here's your winner, Daniel Bryan.
That's an impressive win right there.
Sorry, Prince Puma. Very strong performance in his first showing. And, well, fair play to him. As for Daniel Bryan's next Cruiserweight retention, I believe it will be 2 weeks from tonight. Does that make sense? We've gotten the whole 2 weeks rule. So there we go. 2 weeks from tonight, Daniel Bryan will defend his Cruiserweight Championship. And, of course, if you want to, you know, when you want to choose who that is, leave it down in the comments below, as always. You could even go for Prince Puma off of his performance. Actually, no, you can't. No, you can't, because he did have a match against Neville before Bryan took the belt. So you cannot vote for Prince Puma. Sorry about that. You can vote for a lot of other people aside from Neville and Prince Puma. There we go. That's going to decide that. We're going to move on to our next contest now. Chris Benoit against Chad Gable. Benoit, last night, able, of course, to pick up that win along with Brian Pillman. The Killer Elite squad is World Tag Team Champions, their reign continuing on. The question that I did ask after their match at SummerSlam still holds on today, the day after. Yep, that's a long time. Who can stop them? Like, genuinely, who can stop the Killer Elite squad right now. American Alpha have had two opportunities and they failed both times. Benoit and Pillman, sorry about that, are pretty much the perfect combination together. They've been able to work together so well that it just begs the question of who can stop them. And here's Gable with his towel. My goodness. Chad Gable. That does say SummerSlam in the background. I can certainly tell you that was last night. Chad Gable, though, he seems like... got momentum. He's feeling it. He's feeling the hype in the arena here tonight as he makes his way down towards the ring. It seems if he's not letting last night bog him down. However, Chad Gable can show all the enthusiasm in the world he wants to. Fact of the matter is, he's going one-on-one with one half of the World Tag Team Champions and a guy who was able to keep Chad Gable stuck in his corner last night. So, you know, this enthusiasm's nice to see, but at the end of the day, it's not really doing all that much towards helping him get a win in a way. Could even be a... I don't know what the word I'm looking for is. I'm gonna drop that. I can't think of what it was. He throws the towel anyway, and Chad Gable ready to go against Benoit. This is a one-on-one matchup, and I don't think I have to remind anyone. Oh, here we go. Both men squaring off. Benoit went for a quick kick, but now we're gonna get a corner elbow tie-up here. Benoit now wrenching on that arm. Look at this, just got a good lock on it right here. Benoit now completely wrenching it and getting a easy win at the start of a Gable. Gable pulls off an elbow there. Look out. Reversal back by Benoit. As we start things off with a little bit of technicality, followed up by a strike by Benoit. And good counter there by Gable, who attacks the arm. Elbow to the face there by Benoit. Good strike to follow up. Oh, God, it didn't take long. There's a German. Benoit already firing up the German suplexes. Exactly. Kick to the gut, Fisherman suplex maybe. Oh, so quick with it. That was such a quick Fisherman suplex there. It was almost as if he literally had no time at all to recover. Irish whip there with a quick arm drag.
No one was expecting. I certainly didn't expect to see this kind of damage.
Gable right now. Oh, headbutt to Benoit. That's one. That's more so one of Benoit's maneuvers, but seems if Gable is going to be the one to use that. Counter though by Benoit now as he tries to get himself back in this matchup. Went for the Fisherman suplex maybe. Oh, beautiful enziguri counter by Benoit there. Timed it to perfection. German suplex number two. God, down goes Gable. Counter back by Gable, though, who looks for something. Benoit having none of it. Quickly counters there. Went for a strike, and Gable counters again. There's another forearm. Benoit throws him away there. And German number three. Oh, my God. Painful start here. And Benoit is actually heading to the top rope. Here we go. Benoit might take flight here. The Crippler. Diving headbutt. Will we see two tap out? Will we see two submission victories here tonight? Is it going to be 2-0 for the champions? Benoit locking in the Crippler crossface. Daniel Bryan just went with a very similar maneuver. But can Benoit get the win with his version of it? He can't. Gable not tapping out. Wow. Chop countered by Gable. Oh my God. Huge German by Gable, making Benoit flip in the air. Get up to his feet here, and Gable now clothesline. For the clothesline, another one. And ducks under. Power slam, or scoop slam even. To Benoit. Got a leg here. He's turning around. Oh, he's got an ankle lock here. On Chad, on Chris Benoit. Will Benoit tap out? No, he won't. Will Gable go for the pin? Yes, he will. No, he won't. Okay. Attacking the arm now. I believe when Gable has won matches in the past by himself, he usually goes for the triple Germans. That is not a German. That's an attempted slam. Benoit pushes him away. Gives him a stiff forearm there. And now he's going to treat Gable to the triple Germans. There's one. Two. Gable doesn't look like he's going to be able to get out of this. and the third. Gable, I think, is out. Cover by Benoit. One, two, three. No! Wow, Gable kicking out of two there. Still showing some fight is Chad Gable. Question is for how much longer? Oh, it might not be that much. Second crippler crossface. Gable trying to crawl, but it's not going to be much use. He won't have enough time to crawl, and Benoit has just wrapped this match up. There's the tap out by Gable. There's the win for Benoit. This is put to rest. Killer Elite Squad decimating American Alpha, not only at SummerSlam, but the night after as well. Benoit making it look almost easy, but they got the win there. Fair play to Benoit. Gable really did try, but he was just so out of his element. Benoit just destroying him in that ring. Technical masterclass is what you can expect from Chris Benoit, and we saw it here tonight. Suplexes all over the place, and the crippler crossface to end it. So the champion's looking good right now. Will they make it 3-0? Well, that's what we're about to find out as Jay Lethal takes on the new United States champion, Christian. It is Jay Lethal coming towards the ring, still with SummerSlam behind him. Making his way to the ring from Asbury Park, New Jersey, Mr. Macho Jay Lee. Jay Lethal heading down towards the ring right now. Good opportunity for Lethal here in his in this matchup. Could get a win over the new United States champion. You never know what could happen. What will we see when Jay Lethal locks horns with Christian? I don't know, but Jay Lethal right now, with the new champion being crowned, could hit the reset switch on contenders, and a win here for Lethal could mean an awful lot, could mean a future opportunity at that United States Championship. We'll see what's going to happen there, but I'm looking forward to seeing what the new United States Champion looks like. It was something when last night, Christian defeated Tyler Breeze, pinned him in the middle of the ring off of that kill switch. Tyler Breeze almost had the match ended with a beauty shot, but Christian kicked out of that, fought through it, and captured the United States Championship. His first title in over a year. Captain Charisma is back, and with that United States Championship around his waist. Congratulations to Christian for last night. Commiserations to Tyler Breeze on what was one of the most successful, and I would say one of the most promising United States Championship reigns we've seen. Because a lot of US title reigns we see, you see the guy, yes, he gets elevation from the title, of course, but at the same time, sometimes it's a made guy, you know? It's Christian, in a way, is a made guy. Former Intercontinental Champion, former Tag Team Champion, has fought for the world title before. Yes, Tyler Breeze had fought for the world title before, and yes, Tyler Breeze was King of the Ring. But those had happened within 3 months of each other. So it was a bit shaky on that behalf. So all I can say, really, is congratulations to Tyler Breeze on taking that US title, not only running with it for 4 months, nearly 5 months, but for being able to use it to further uplift himself. I said this last night at SummerSlam. I do think we have the potential of a future world heavyweight champion in Tyler Breeze, and I still stand by that, even after his loss to Christian. We'll see what's going to happen regarding that. Of course, I don't think Tyler Breeze would really want to get locked in the whole Finn Balor situation going on right now. But nevertheless, Christian and Jay Lethal. Here we go. These two men going to lock up here, and it's Jay Lethal had his back turned to him for a second. Christian tried to take advantage. Didn't work out. Jay Lethal right off the bow with a slam down there onto Christian. Not happy with that right off the right underway. Slamming down Captain Charisma, the new United States champion. His first opponent being the second longest reigning? I believe it is at this point. I believe Jay Lethal was still able to hold on to that right. Shoulder tackle down rather easily though by Christian. Chopped across the face more than the chest. Reverses the Irish whip. Christian backs out into a collar and elbow tie-up. That's just what I think when I think backing out of the corner. Get a break here. Oh, Christian with a cheap shot. Jay Lethal didn't seem too happy about it. He's relaxed now. Forearm across the face. And now, oh, look at that quick jab. Elbow to the back of the head. And now Lethal locking him in a front face lock there and just kneeing away on the stomach. And then one on the face. For good measure. Tried running at him there. Good counter. Triangle headlock there. And now elbows across the head. Stomp down. Christian is getting things going here at the start of this match. Kick to the gut. Oh, nice uppercut. I don't think I've seen that before from Christian. Jay Lethal now in a little bit of trouble, but Lethal able to pull out a good counter there. Good uppercut followed by a bulldog. Jay Lethal going to hit the top rope now. What will we see? From Lethal, went for double knees there. Christian moved out of the way, but it doesn't seem as if it's affected Lethal that much. Counter now by Lethal. Good punch. Running clothesline. And Lethal feeling a little bit confident about himself. I wouldn't stop attacking in the ring with the United States champion there with a good opportunity for you. And there's that slam again. Another elbow there, and now Lethal, he was looking for something, gets reverse sent into the turnbuckle. Good running drop kick by Christian there. Pinpoint accuracy on the chest, and now slamming Jay Lethal's head into the mat. What's Christian going to look for here? And send him down, and chin lock. Great, just what we needed, a break in the action. Yep, great. Christian, though, doesn't seem as if he's going to have this in for much longer. Jay Lethal fighting out here. Lethal really testing the United States champion in his first showing. Uh-oh, real big problems for Christian. Pile driver! Lethal, after the pile driver, now going to hit the top rope. Lethal feeling it. Top rope elbow. Nails it! Cover by Lethal after it. Can he pull off an upset and defeat Christian? One, two, no! Christian barely lifting a shoulder up in time there. Christian's lucky this ref can't count to three. And he gets out of the way. Good catch there by Christian. Sent, sweeps the leg away. But no, not a Boston Crab. Texas Cloverleaf. Oh my God, Jay Lethal's legs just locked up there. I believe that's a Texas Cloverleaf. Looks like one anyway. Christian releases it. Lethal rolls out of the way. Both men went for a kick to the gut. Lethal strikes first. Beautiful timed Inzaghi. Beautifully timed Inzaghi, I should say. Roll up now by Lethal. Looking to try and quickly steal one over the US champion. We got one. We got two. No, we don't even have two, actually. Getting a bit ahead of myself. Flip over by Christian, and Lethal quickly getting out of that, and apparently pings up to his feet so very quickly. Forearm to the face there by Christian. Turns around, reverse DDT, signature maneuver. Christian could feel the momentum here and could be feeling a victory. There's one. That's about it, actually. Wow. One count. Continuing on here. Oh, dropkick barely connected with Christian. Apparently it did connect, though. Kind of surprised that it had enough momentum to bring down the United States champion. Neck breaker by Lethal. Thanks for watching, everyone. Kick back, relax, and enjoy your Monday night with some great WWE action. Lethal picking him up. Uh-oh, second pile driver incoming. Planting him down again. My God. And pile drivers must take a whole lot out of Christian. He might be in trouble here. Lethal lifting him up. Front face lock. Oh, if Lethal's going to take him to the ropes, we might be in for something. Oh, here we go. Reverses it. Handstand. Lethal injection. The Lethal injection. Can Jay Lethal pull off an upset? Is he on the verge of defeating the new United States champion? Cover by Lethal. We get one from it. Two. No. Christian. Wow. Last second powering out there. Christian just trying everything in his power to stay in this one. Quick jab there by Lethal. Second quick jab countered. Kick to the gut. Christian looking for something. Lethal denying him. Russian leg sweep. Lethal trying to get something going here. Oh, Christian counters. German suplex. for the former United States champion. Christian turns him over here. Cover after that German. Can he get him here? He's got one, two, and not three. Jay Lethal getting the shoulder up, and once again this match continuing on. I imagine much to the dismay of Christian, who would have wanted this match to be over quite a while ago. But Lethal is proving a difficult opponent to say the least. Quick roll up by Christian here. Really trying to steal one. Cover. One. And no, not even two. Both men looking for quick wins, it seems. Christian again picking up Lethal. Lethal counters. Oh, gets kneed in the face for his troubles by Christian. Up on his shoulders here. Counter, reverse DDT. Sends him down there for a snapmare and a kick to the back. Jay Lethal, look at him. He looks exhausted there. And again, Christian countering. Both men seeming exhausted. Christian with Lethal up on his shoulders. Fireman's carry flapjack. And Christian having to take a moment to catch his breath there. Oh, I thought he might be going for something in the turnbuckle. Well, he's going to attack the leg instead. Alrighty. Christian lifting up. Jay Lethal. Lethal counters whatever Christian was looking for there. Went for a jab and Christian counters it. Gets a punch in on Jay Lethal now. Irish whip into the corner. My goodness, these guys really going back and forth. Spinning heel kick to the face there by Christian. Catches the leg though. Lethal immediately countering with a dragon screw. God, one of these guys is going to have to go down for the three count or the submission. Just asks which one it's going to be. I got to tell you, these guys are in the best shape I've ever seen. Lethal counted again. Taking too long once he gets up to his feet. Brilliant DDT counter by Christian. Flips him over. Oh, he's locked in an arm by. I thought he might be going for someone else then. That's disappointing. Christian picks him up. Lethal sent down with another snap mate. And another chin lock. Once again, Christian trying to slow the pace, but he can barely get a second to catch a breather. Counter by Lethal. Christian has him up on his shoulders. Another fireman's carry flapjack, and again we've got blood. Raw really going all out here. Christian might look for the kill switch. If he can get it, this match is going to be over. Christian, no, stuffed by Lethal. And Lethal again countered. Okay, that makes sense. Yeah, you attacked the arm. You attacked the arm, and now he's going for the pin. Christian, you are a bit out of your mind there, mate. The elbow drop and the lethal injection have not put away Christian. If he had nailed that kill switch, that this match may have been put to rest. Up on his shoulders again. Single knee gut buster. Just ask the. Oh my fucking god! What the hell's going on? Just ask the question, what does Christian have to do to put him away? I think he might have found the answer. Something from the top rope. Elbow drop. No, I don't think that's enough, Christian. Counter. Wow, Christian just... he's fighting back with everything he's got, but he's just not getting any offense on the go. Any strong offense that can for sure put Lethal away. That was a nice jab. Counter by Christian again. And a Russian leg sweep. In essence, Jay Lethal should have put this match away a long time ago, and the fact that he hasn't is costing him in these latter stages now of the match. Both men exhausted. Oh, God, from the top rope again. Elbow drop. This time he gets it. There's a replay of it right into the chest. Jay Lethal, has he beat Christian this time? There's one, there's two, there's three. Lethal has defeated Christian in Christian's first match as United States champion. Jay Lethal is victorious. I am somewhat surprised by this. Jay Lethal defeats Christian, my goodness. Fair play there. I mean, don't really know what to say. It was Jay Lethal's match in a way. He was in control for the majority of it, and he deserves that win there. Jay Lethal, your winner. That's all I really have to say on the matter. I think we may be looking at the future number one contender for the United States Championship. But anyway, we're going to move on to our next contest. AJ Styles against the new World Heavyweight Champion, Finn Balor. Styles heading towards the ring right now and spicing up his entrance a little bit. Why not? We just came off of SummerSlam. If you want to spice things up, I think now's the time to do it. AJ Styles heading towards the ring right now. The first opponent for the new World Heavyweight Champion, Finn Balor. We've just seen that new champions are 1-1. Daniel Bryan, of course, winning against Prince Puma earlier night. And as we just saw, Jay Lethal being defeated by Christian. Can that give Finn Balor some momentum? Could, you know, it persuade him to think that he can for sure beat Finn Balor? But the big question on my mind right now, it's been 9 months since Finn Balor lost that championship. It's been 8 months that he's been the demon. Has Finn Balor's time as the demon come to an end? Has his quest come to an end? Is Finn Balor back to the one we know and love? The answer seems to be yes. No demon paint. This is just quite simply a jacket and the old Finn Balor. But that look, that menacing look from Finn Balor, still asks the question, just because he's not looking like a demon, does it make a difference to Finn Balor? He's still getting the boos from the crowd that he got at SummerSlam and he's had ever since February, basically. Finn Balor, as I just said, that look, that is not the Finn Balor look. That's almost a different look. The look of an evil man. A man who's proud of what he did last night. A man who's proud of what he's done for these last 8 months, wreaking havoc on Raw. Him and Sting threatening to take over Raw, and I imagine those two still together, Sting lurking somewhere in the rafters, but right now, the main focus is Finn Balor, and the main focus is that Finn Balor is World Heavyweight Champion, winning it, as I said, exactly a year after he won his first world title. Finn Balor and AJ Styles in the main event of Monday Night Raw. What an entertaining matchup this is going to be between these two men. How will the new World Heavyweight Champion fare is what we're about to find out.
There's the bell, and here we go.
It is a weird sight, actually. For the first time, think about it, for the first time this year, Finn Balor is not in any sort of demon attire. He hasn't got any kind of paint on him, but still somewhat acting like the old Finn Balor. Cheap shots there. Sling Blade as the referee was trying to hold him back there and getting in the way of AJ Styles. So it does ask, you know, is there anything different? Is his demon persona now just taken over him for good? That's what I personally think. I think that even though he's not got the face paint on, even though he's not decked out like he was last night at SummerSlam, I don't think it's made a difference. I think Finn Balor is the same guy. I think the demon mentality he had has just eroded away the old Finn Balor. Hence the boos he got tonight from the crowd, which, to be fair, he did deserve. And AJ Styles now looking to kick off Finn Balor's World Heavyweight Championship campaign with a loss. Discus forearm with a great counter there. It's just a dumping spine buster. Kick to the back by Styles. I would love to see these guys square off for the World Heavyweight Championship. That would be a match and a half, in my opinion. Finn Balor, single and hook suplex there. And quickly going to hit the top rope now. What can Finn Balor look for here? Elbow drop, but Styles rolls out of the way and almost got boots in the back there. It's so simple. And now AJ Styles, oh, stomped at the chest of Finn Balor. And now, oh, Finn Balor was trying to just getting kicked now. Repeated kicks there by Balor. Counter here, shoulder tackle by the World Heavyweight Champion. You gotta imagine Kid, who is spending the night at home, is gonna be watching this match closely, seeing the World Heavyweight Championship around the waist of Finn Balor. I cannot imagine what that makes Tyson Kidd feel like. Working so hard to get that championship, working so hard to hold on to it, only for this man to get in his mind and lose the title. The mind games were effective by Finn Balor. And now the big question is, will he be able to replicate the success he had in his first world title reign, and also when the imminent rematch hopefully comes between those two men? Will Finn Balor be able to prove that lightning can strike twice in more ways than one? Can he beat Tyson Kidd a second time if that match comes around? Back suplex there. AJ Styles going to take things up to the top rope here. The Phenomenal One looking to fly. AJ Styles, interesting frog splash. My goodness. Almost didn't connect with it. Oh, went for the neck crank there from the side. Didn't connect with that. Finn Balor going to make him play, going to make him pay here with a bloody hell. Nails it down.
Wait, is he still conscious? Man, that looked bad. In a relatively short amount of time, Finn Balor
Irish whip now. Just sending his back careening there into the ring post. Counter though, however, by AJ Styles. Looking for something. Finn Balor quickly gets off and pushes AJ Styles away. Good strike across the face though by Styles. Lifts him up on his shoulders now. Oh, beautiful fireman's carry neckbreaker. And now AJ Styles feeling some momentum here. He's telling him to get up to his feet. Is Styles going to look for the Styles Clash? Or is he looking for his comeback? Oh, forearm. Forearm. And oh my word. Wow, what a counter by Finn Balor. And now Balor looking to wrap this up. This is no longer named the Bloody Sunday. It has been aptly renamed to 1916. And he nails it down onto AJ Styles. Has the Phenomenal One been put away by the Demon? Cover. One, two. No, AJ Styles gets the shoulder up at two. Phenomenal One staying in this. The leader of the aptly named Balor Club.
Remember, momentum in WWE.
Still the one in control. Kick to the gut. Pushes him away here. Sunset flip. Pin after it. Trying to put away Styles any way possible. Can he get... No, he almost got three there. The ref's hand was coming down and AJ Styles gets the shoulder up in time. Up on his shoulders again. Are we going to see that neck breaker? Oh no, we're going to see a, what's it called, a cradle, I don't know, fireman's carry cradle driver, I think, something like that. Might just be a cradle driver. Styles anyway up on the top rope. We're going to see that frog splash again. No, we might see 450. Beautiful 450 splash. Cover after it by Styles. There's one. Oh my word, it's only a one count. Finn Balor out at one there. Rolls out of the way. AJ Styles looking for the calf crusher. Calf crusher on Finn Balor, the world champion. Looking to try and get out of this. And he does. AJ Styles may have released the hold as well. Maybe realizing that Balor wasn't going to tap out. Cover here, there's one. And yeah, that's it. I don't know why he goes for the pin after it. Stay on the offense. Now look, you're just on your knees and behind you. Meanwhile, Finn Balor's up to his feet and is going to hit a brain. What is he going to go for? Brain buster.
Complete domination here. He is just getting busted up.
Finn Balor going to look for a second bloody hell. And AJ Styles completely caught by it. Now what? Oh, never mind. Finn, I was about to say, what is Finn Balor going to look for? But he just answered my own question. Finn Balor to the top rope to put away AJ Styles. Coup de grace! The world champion nails the coup de grace down onto AJ Styles. The cover here. One, two, and no! What? AJ Styles kicking out of both 1916 and the coup de grace. Spinning kick there, countered by Styles, who has him in a front face lock now. Elbow to the back. AJ Styles needs to get some huge offense going if he wants to beat Finn Balor now. Lovely forearm there by Finn, and a discus forearm to follow up with.
Boy, he just got laid out.
Balor now picking up AJ Styles. Might be feeling the momentum here. He's doing his little... Oh, never mind. There's a counter by Styles. Looking for a slam. Finn Balor gets out of it. German suplex. AJ Styles caught by that. Finn Balor picks him up. And now the forearm. And another one. And a sling blade. My word. AJ Styles has fought through a lot and he's still fighting. Counters the Irish whip here. Kick to the back and takes him down. Top rope here. Once again by AJ Styles. Can he pull something out of the bag? 450. Incoming. Missed. Finn Balor dodges the 450 splash. And now another 1916. He gets it. Now that's a finishing move, people. 1916. Down goes AJ Styles. The cover by Balor. 1, 2, 3. This one does it. Finn Balor puts away AJ Styles in his first match as World Heavyweight Champion.
Here's your winner, Finn Balor.
And there's your winner, ladies and gentlemen. It's all about wins and losses, and it sure looks to me like somebody
Finn Balor there.
When you see that, you have
good
no
win for him. It's nice to see Finn Balor actually back to normal. But as I said at the start of this match, just because Finn Balor looks back to normal doesn't mean he is back to normal, and nor do I think will he ever return to the old Finn Balor that we knew before Sting got his hands on him. Finn Balor, your winner here tonight, the new world champion looking good, the new cruiserweight champion looking good, the new United States champion, however, looking rocky. A good win for Jay Lethal, a good upset victory on top of that. Can Jay Lethal take the momentum going forth and be able to use it to his advantage, perhaps to get a future shot against Christian? I don't know. Big question right now, though, regarding this. Finn Balor as world champion. There are two targets, two big targets coming for him. One, Tyson Kidd, the former world champion, the guy who wants the rematch. Two, the man who has a score to settle with Finn Balor, Mr. Money in the Bank, Shinsuke Nakamura. Finn Balor better keep his eyes watched out. Better keep his eyes peeled. There we go. Watched out. What the fuck kind of word is that? Better keep his eyes peeled for these two. Sting can fight his battles, but he can't fight them forever. Finn Balor can only be protected for so long before he's going to have to fight one of these guys. And with Nakamura, of course, it can be any time Nakamura pleases. That's going to end this episode of Raw. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, guys. And ta-ra.